Magandang araw, kapamilya. Today is Sunday, Feast of Christ the King. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. How worthy is the Lamb who was slain to receive power and divinity and wisdom and strength and honor. To Him belong glory and power forever and ever.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest.
And on earth, peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
And let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, whose will is to restore all things in your beloved Son, the King of the universe, grant, we pray, that the whole creation, set free from slavery, may render your majesty service and ceaselessly proclaim your praise. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
First reading, a reading from the book of the prophet Daniel. As the visions during the night continued, I saw one like a son of man coming on the clouds of heaven. When he reached the Ancient One and was presented before him, the one like a son of man received dominion, glory, and kingship. All peoples, nations, and languages serve him. His dominion is an everlasting dominion that shall not be taken away. His kingship shall not be destroyed. The Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Let our response be, the Lord is King, He is robed in majesty.
The Lord is King, He is robed in majesty.
The Lord is King, in splendor robed. Robed is the Lord and girt about with strength.
The Lord is King, He is robed with majesty.
And He has made the word firm, not to be moved. Your throne stands firm from of old. From everlasting you are, O Lord.
The Lord is King, He is robed in majesty.
Your decrees are worthy of trust, indeed. Holiness befits your house, O Lord, for length of days.
The Lord is King, He is robed in majesty.
Second reading, a reading from the book of Revelation. Jesus Christ is the faithful witness, the firstborn of the dead and ruler of the kings of the earth. To Him who loves us and has freed us from our sins by His blood, who has made us into a kingdom, priests for His God and Father, to Him be glory and power forever and ever. Amen. Behold, He is coming amid the clouds, and every eye will see Him, even those who pierced Him. All the peoples of the earth will lament Him. Yes, amen. I am the Alpha and the Omega, says the Lord, the One who is, and who was, and who is to come, the Almighty. The Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, Alleluia. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the kingdom of our father David that is to come. Alleluia, Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Pilate said to Jesus, "Are you the king of the Jews?" Jesus answered, "Do you say this on your own, or have others told you about me?" Pilate answered, "I am not a Jew, am I? Your own nation and the chief priests handed you over to me. What have you done?" Jesus answered, "My kingdom does not belong to this world. If my kingdom did belong to this world, my attendants would be fighting to keep me from being handed over to the Jews. As it is, my kingdom is not here." So Pilate said to him, "Then you are king of the Jews?" Jesus answered, "You say I am king. For this I was born, and for this I came into the world, to testify to the truth. Everyone who belongs to the truth listens to my voice." My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Ngayon ho, ay ano, no, katapusan ng liturgical year, no? So tapusan, isang taon na naman ang tapos, no? And then next year, magsisimula na tayo ng panibagong liturgical year, the first Sunday of Advent, no? And today I just want to invite you to reflect on one point, you know, the very end of the gospel. But let me just give two preliminary introductions, so to speak, no? And at the beginning of the gospel, makikita nyo nagsasagutan si Poncio Pilato at ang Panginoon, no? So Pilate asks him, "Are you the king of the Jews?" And then notice how Christ really changes the roles, ano? Instead of being interrogated, siya yung tinatanong, siya yung nagtanong kay Pilate. And he tells Pilate, "Are you saying this on your own, or did someone tell you? Meron bang nagsulsul sa'yo, o ito ba ay talagang katanungan mo?" Because remember, Pilate was the representatives of Rome. And therefore, if Jesus pretended to be king, he could be killed for treason, no? Because that is parang usurping the power of the emperor. So, but here you see Christ in, again, reversal of roles, no? Are you asking this because you want to know on your own, or someone told you? May nagsusul ba sa'yo, no? So I think it's very important, no? That Christ was very aware of the political, you might say, implications of what was going on between him and Pilate. So that first important point, no? Not, well, important for the context, no? That Christ was not blind to what was going on around him. Hindi siya yung dead man, no, sa mga political wrangling during that time, no. And then the second one is ano, "My kingdom is not of this world." That's a second context that I invite you to reflect on, no. And I think when we see this, you realize that the Lord made this choice in the agony in the garden. I think that's very important for us to understand also. In the agony in the garden, he once and for all surrenders everything to God. And that's why he says, "My kingdom is not of this world. My way is the way of the cross." No? That he knew very well that his mission was to die on the cross, and that was the way, that was not just the what and the why of his mission, but that was how he was going to fulfill his mission. So itong sagot niyang to, di ba, is part of the clarity of his mission. No? I think that's the second context that I want to lay out. No? Then finally, the main point that I want you to reflect on as we celebrate the feast of Christ the King. Jesus finally answers Pilate in the end. When Pilate says, "Then you are a king," and Jesus answered, "You say I am king. For this I was born, and for this I came into the world, to testify to the truth. Everyone who belongs to the truth listens to my voice." Remember, this is reminiscent of the prologue of John, the Gospel of John, from which we read this Sunday. In the beginning was the Word, diba? And the Word was made flesh, and the Word was to proclaim the glory of the Father. So binabalikan ng Panginoon yung simula niya, no? The mystery of the incarnation, that was the beginning of his mission, no? And then to proclaim the glory of God and to give us the truth, no? The truth of God's kingship over the whole of creation. No? And here you have the source of the moral authority of Jesus. Here you have the source of his kingship, that he is the king because he was sent into the world for his mission, and he is now fulfilling that mission with great fidelity, with great fidelity, with great constancy and great prudence. No, because when you think about it, according to the commentaries, no, that during that time Christ could have turned the tables against Pilate, no, that he had enough followers, he could parang pwede niyang buyuhin yung ibang followers niya kasi konti lang yung sundalong nandun sa Jerusalem noon, so kayang-kaya niyang lumaban. And yet, no, it was very clear to him, no, I witness to the kingship that the Father has intended me to do, the truth of my mission, the truth that I am the beloved Son, and he will prove that truth when he dies on the cross and is raised up by the Father. And today, let us pray for this kingship, the kingship that will give us the truth, the kingship that will again connect us to mission. And for us Christians, that is our mission, to follow the way of Christ, to follow the way of Christ, the cross and the resurrection. And this is the central truth of our faith, that Christ has died, Christ is risen, and Christ will come again. And because of that, he is always eternally our King. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
We now plead our needs, our Almighty Father, who willed to grace us through his Son, Jesus Christ, the King of all. Full of trust, we pray, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May Pope Francis, our Bishop, priests, and deacons work with courage and faith in sowing the seed of the kingdom of God on earth that is now enveloped by fear and discouragement. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May our government officials and all who serve in public office follow the example of Christ the King, who came to serve and not to be served. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May Jesus, our Lord and King, heal and strengthen those who battle against the effects brought about by the COVID-19 pandemic. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
As we close the liturgical year, may Jesus, the King of the universe, be the beginning and end of all our activities in life. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May our beloved dead be welcomed by Jesus, their sure hope and Savior, as they begin their everlasting life. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And let us again remember all the prayers and all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. We also pray for all the souls of the faithful departed, the souls in purgatory, commended to our prayers during this month of November. For all this, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And let us now offer our panalangin para sa halalan 2022. Diyos aming Ama, sa paghahanda namin para sa aming halalan 2022, nagtitiwala kami sa iyong pangako na magpapadala ka sa amin ng mga pinunong naaayon sa iyong puso at diwa. Panginoong Jesus, bigyan inspirasyon mo ang lahat ng naghahangad ng katungkulan upang maging mga pinunong tagapaglingkod na uunahin ang higit na nakabubuti para sa higit na nakararami. Lalong-lalo na ang mga mahihirap, mga nasa laylayan at mga mahina. Higit sa anumang interes sa pansarili o para sa grupo, mga pinunong tagapaglingkod na maghahangad ng katungkulan upang tunay na maglingkod at hindi paglingkuran. mga pinunong tagapaglingkod na maglilingkod na may integridad at tunay na malasakit. Banal na Espiritu, tanglaban ng aming mga isip at puso, nang aming makita ng malinaw ang mga tunay na pangangailangan ng aming mga kapwa Pilipino at kung ano ang pinapangako ng mga kandidato at ang kanilang kakahihang isakatuparan ng mga ito. Nang aming piliin ng tama ang mga pinuno na tunay na mamumuno at maglilingkod, mga pinuno ayon sa iyong sariling puso at diwa, at mga pinuno na magbubuklod at mamumuno sa amin upang gawin naming lahat kung ano ang higit na nakabubuti para sa higit na nakararami at para sa iyong higit na kaluwalhatian. Ama, Anak at Espiritu, Ikaw ang Diyos ng buhay at pag-ibig, ang Panginoon ng kasaysayan. Naway makasama ka namin sa oras na ito ng aming paghahanda para sa darating na halalan. Amen. Birhen ng Fatima,
ipanalangin mo kami.
Immaculada Concepcion, Patron ng Pilipinas,
ipanalangin mo kami.
By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, to your goodness we have this bread and this wine to offer, fruit of the earth, fruit of the vine, and work of human hands. They will become for us our spiritual food, our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
As we offer you, O Lord, the sacrifice by which the human race is reconciled to you, we humbly pray that your Son Himself be bestowed on all nations, may bestow on all nations the gifts of unity and peace through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you anointed your only begotten Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, with the oil of gladness as eternal priest and king of all creation, so that by offering himself on the altar of the cross as a spotless sacrifice to bring us peace, he might accomplish the mysteries of human redemption, and making all created things subject to his rule, he might present to the immensity of your majesty an eternal and universal kingdom, a kingdom of truth and life, a kingdom of holiness and grace, a kingdom of justice, love, and peace. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the unending hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks, he broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Remember, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. We pray most specially for all the souls of the faithful departed, the souls in purgatory, commended to our prayers during this month of November. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Meron lang hong isang bago tayong gagawin ngayong linggo. Matapos ho natin dasalin ng act of spiritual communion, we will spend a minute of silence, no, as part of our communion, spiritual communion with the Lord.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Together, let us pray the Oratio Imperata.
God of mercy and compassion, we come to you in the midst of our sufferings due to the COVID-19 pandemic and ask for your healing love to overcome our fear of sickness and death and to strengthen our faith and hope. We pray for all health workers, protect and sustain them. For those who passed on, reward them with eternal life and consolation for their loved ones. For all who work tirelessly to serve the needs of the people, keep them safe and guide them, most especially our leaders. We pray for the victims of this virus, the dying, and those who died in agony and loneliness. Be their consolation. Embrace them and their families with your love. We pray for families who suffer due to loss of jobs and income, and for all who experience anxiety and fear, may they know they're not alone. Inspire us all to come together in fraternal love for and service to one another. Guide our experts, instruments in your healing hands, to continue to develop effective vaccines and cures for this virus. We ask all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son and our Divine Healer, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petitions in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers. O glorious and ever-blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
Saint Roch.
Pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu.
Have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy.
Have mercy on us.
And let us pray. Having received the food of immortality, we ask, O Lord, that glorifying in obedience to the commands of Christ, the King of the universe, we may live with Him eternally in His heavenly kingdom, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And Almighty God bless us, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Uli po, maraming salamat from Alay Kapwa, from Caritas Philippines. Our total for this week is 41,460,631 pesos and 59 centavos. We are close to setting aside the entire budget for the three-year program for the scholars and for our feeding program. Maraming pong salamat for your continued help. We'll again, once we hit the target, we will again present all the details to you, no? And then also after this, please watch Journeys of Hope. These are two students from Magna Anima Teachers College who will share with you their story of their challenges and yet their hopes and dreams in attaining an education degree to become teachers. So please join us for Journeys of Hope. Marami pong salamat and have a happy Christ the King Sunday. Thank you po.
Purihin ang Diyos at magpasalamat tayo sa Kanya. Ipapatupad na po natin ang ating Ale Kapwa Legacy Program ng Caritas Pilipinas, Pamilya Feeding Program at Educational Assistance Program para sa ating mga kabataan. 6 na mga dioceses ang tatanggap ng tulong para sa Pamilya Feeding Program. Ang dioceses ng Kidapawan, Cotabato, Capiz, Dumaguete, Infanta, at Libmanan. Bawat pamilya po ay bibigyan natin ng 300 pesos every day. At ang bawat diocese ay pipiliin natin ang mga beneficiaries, 60 families for every diocese. At itong tulong ay ibibigay natin for 6 months. Para naman sa ating educational assistance program, 10 mga dioceses ang bibigyan natin ng tulong. Ang dioceses ng Bontoc, Basilan, Hulo, Marawi, Libmanan, Infanta, Dumaguete, Capiz, Cotabato, at Kidapawan. Bawat diocese po ay pipili ng 50 na mga kabataan. At ang bawat bata na ating tutulungan ay bibigyan natin ng 10,000 pesos. At maliban dyan, ay tutulungan pa natin na magkaroon sila ng mga gadgets para sa kanilang pag-aaral. Ang lahat po nito ay ating ginagawa upang ang ating mga kababayan ay maiangat natin sa kanilang paghihirap at mabigyan natin ng magandang kinabukasan ang ating mga kabataan. Tulungan niyo po ang Caritas Pilipinas. Magtulungan po tayo para sa ating bayan. Kapwa ko, pananagutan ko.